Well, I got a lot to say about the spud from Idaho. There's so much I didn't know, like how the wild thing grows. Name another plant that turns into such a treat. I know the mash can be, I'm good for goodness sake, but there's only one brew that I apply. It don't get no better than a French fry. Chicken and fries, barbecue too. There's more you can do. Steak and feet, bon appetit. Sushi and fries, bacon soup. French fries, can't have a burger without them. French fries, you got another combo, just shout. Omelets and fries. Tuna and fry, a grilled cheese makes the fry taste good. Canada chips in London town too. I love the feet, they just can't be beat. French fries, can't have a burger without them. French fries, if you got another combo, just shout on. Nowadays they come up with better ways, healthy ways to make my day. Let's grab some out and start a job. Thank you.
Hey there, Kitchen Mutants. It is your favorite Daddy Man in the kitchen. It's Friday night, and I am your favorite Daddy Man in the kitchen. How'd I forget that after 50 episodes? Welcome to, oh, and that can only be one thing. It's time for Mutant Cafe Live. Wow, way to F that all the way up. Welcome to the Mutant Cafe Kitchen. Once again, it is Friday night. You made it another week. These weeks feel like they're getting harder and harder, but it's almost summertime. And we are in the 6 out of 9 episodes of State Fair Food. Tonight we are doing Detroit, and I am saying Detroit because we are making Detroit Coney Chili Dog Fries or Chili Fries. Normally, if you're from the Detroit area or if you've ever been to the Detroit area, there are a lot of Coney Islands. There's two franchises that kind of compete a little bit, but they both have this amazing, very distinct Coney, no beans. It's just beef and onions and lots of spices. They put it on their Coneys, and better than that, they put it on their fries. So not only are we going to make that Coney, that delicious chili, I keep wanting to say Coney because I'm starving. We're not only making that delicious chili, but I'm going to show you how to make the best French fries that you've ever had. I promise you, these are gonna taste just like those French fries that you stand in line for at all the carnivals and festivals and fairs and things like that. They're not very hard. There's just a couple steps. It's not as easy as opening up a bag of frozen fries. I get it, I do that all the time. But these are totally worth a little bit of extra time. If you're only doing the fries, honestly, you can do this quick beginning part and get them in the water, let them soak for half an hour or up to 24 hours. And then the frying takes literally 10 minutes for a giant batch of like four people. So We have a lot to do because we are both making the fries and the chili. So let's hit those ingredients as we always do. Thank you guys, if I didn't say it already, for joining me once again this week. 3 more weeks to go. I'll tell you about the next 2 weeks in a little bit. So we're going to start with 4 medium to large russet potatoes. I use the russet potatoes. They are hearty. They hold up to the oil. You can definitely use a Yukon Gold if you would like. They might get a little mushy. So that's why I use these. Try to get them kind of straight and narrow. Think about your fries. You don't want them all bendy and weird. So 4 of those, okay? You're going to need some vegetable oil for frying. I'm using a 14-inch cast iron skillet this time instead of the 10-inch. You want that about a third to a half full. Now, full disclosure, I'm not exclusively using vegetable oil this time. I'm using about half vegetable oil, half Crisco, because Crisco is awesome for frying. It's lard, basically. It gives it a nice flavor, and it has a good temperature, doesn't smoke very easily. So that combination seems to work. Don't have to use Crisco full on. Use the vegetable oil that we've been using all of these weeks. And I said it last week, I'm going to say it again this week. You could probably like put your arm over the pan and squeeze it out. We've been eating so much fried food. So salt and pepper, 1 pound of ground beef. I use the ground sirloin because it does not have a lot of fat in it. There's enough grease going on with fries. So use something that has a low grease content, fat content. You're going to need 1 tablespoon of chili powder. Also, 1 teaspoon of celery salt. You can go a little lighter on that if you don't want these fries super salty, because you are going to salt them in the end. Okay? 1 teaspoon of cumin. 1 medium onion. And this is a smaller onion. That's okay. This is not, you need a lot of onions. 3 garlic cloves. 2 tablespoons of brown sugar. I use the dark brown sugar. 2 teaspoons of yellow mustard. And I use good old Heinz yellow mustard. We're going to use a little bit more later. There's 1 teaspoon here, and I'm going to do 1 teaspoon out of the bottle. Okay? 2 teaspoons of tomato paste, and 1.5 cups of beef stock. And again, full disclosure, I went less than that. 1.5 came out a little too runny for me, so I'm going to go about 1.25. You might need 1.5. There is 1.5 in here, but I may not use it all. Okay? 12 ounces of cheddar cheese, please, by all means, more or less, depending on your taste, and sharp or mild, depending on your taste as well. 16 cherry tomatoes. This is not 16. I'm not doing the full batch, ultimately, so I just grabbed a big old handful, whatever kind of cherry tomatoes you like. So we're going to start with the potatoes. So let me get some of the stuff out of the way so you can see the potatoes. I do have the oil on. You want to get that going. We ultimately, we're going to do 2 different temperatures. That's something different we're doing with the frying. We're going to first start at 300 degrees, then we're going to kick it up to 350. So get that oil up to 300 degrees, and then find somewhere on your burner where you can kind of keep it at a nice 300. You could actually go to 350 right now, because when you put those potatoes in, that temperature is going to sink down quickly. All right, so let's start with my waste bowl. We're gonna peel these potatoes. I don't need to tell you how to peel potatoes. If you are like me, that was always a kid's job. I've peeled a million potatoes. But the one thing you are gonna do is you're gonna leave the ends, because what that's gonna do is, you know, when you go to the fair, you get all those little crispy ends that have the skin still on them, but then the nice, smooth, golden potatoes. So keep the ends, the peels on. We're gonna peel these, and, pretty easy. Easy, easy, easy. All right. 3 more weeks. Or this is, yeah, this is 3 and then 2 more weeks. It's been fun. But again, lots and lots of fried food. Y'all like fried food. You have lots of suggestions for fried food. Next week is sort of fried, but not exactly. Next week is fried in butter. So slightly different. And then the week after that, we are not frying, I promise you. The grand finale is not frying. The sad thing is, there's only 3 more episodes of The Last Drive-In. How sad does that make you? Then, according to Darcy, they're taking a little break hopefully only for a couple weeks. I'm hoping they come back to me, timing-wise. It seems like maybe they'll take a couple weeks back and come back for July 4th, around July 4th, which would be their anniversary of the original marathon. That would be awesome sauce. I'd love to see something like Friday the 13th, 24-hour marathon. Never going to happen, but how awesome would that be? I mean, never say never, right? Nightmare on Elm Street. I've already done some Halloween. There's all kinds of stuff they could do. It's a lot of good summer horror. When we were doing that Memorial Day little gig, there's all kinds of summer horror. So again, you still have to be perfect. The fries you get at the carnival are not by any means perfect, but they are going to taste delicious, trust me. All right, we're almost done. See how easy that is? Peeling is not a big deal. I remember making a big deal about it when I was a kid, but we also used to do like 20-pound bags of potatoes because my brother likes potatoes. I do too, but my brother really will sit there and eat potatoes. Mashed potatoes. This was his idea, actually.
He just Thank said you. Nice tiger shirt.
Who said?
Your brother.
My brother, yeah. Thank you. I was hoping you could see it. I didn't know if you could actually see it. Detroit Tigers. It's the only one I have. I have. We've been here for 10 years, so I guess I need a new one. I need a lot of t-shirts. All right. So we're done peeling. Here's what we're going to cut each of these potatoes in half again, so we have a flat surface. And then we're going to cut 1/3 to 1/4 inch slices for both. Just depending on how thick you like them. And then we're going to take half that stack again so we have a flat surface, and we're going to do 1/4 to 1/3 again. Okay? Make sure they all come apart and get them in the water. Now, the reason we're sticking these in the water for at least 25 minutes-ish. Might not be 25 minutes tonight. Y'all might have to be just slightly behind me. Is because that removes all the starch from the potato, or a lot of the starch from the potato, which helps it fry up and get really nice and crispy. When that starch hits the oil, kind of sucks in the oil, which you don't want your potato to be all soggy. You want it to be fried on the outside and soft and tender on the inside, right? All right, so half a potato. Let Hubs's, as always, on the keyboard in the YouTube chat room. And again, Twitter people, I see you talking. I apologize that we're not answering back. I gotta get like Hubs number two or something. Maybe when quarantine's over, I'll convince somebody else to work for free and man the Twitter. You need like a Darcy on the Twitter. But if you do have any questions, make sure you're @ing Mutant Cafe, and Hubs will get that question to you, and I'll pretend I know the answer, because most of the time I'm just flubbing around and not really knowing what I'm saying. All right, got this in here. Two more potatoes to go. This is really the hardest part of this recipe, is cutting these taters. But yeah, jump over on YouTube. YouTube is fun. There's a chat room over there. And in fact, I like the chat room better on YouTube than Twitter. And someone asked me why I do this. Someone who's new to the show asked why I do this. I, for a long time, had all my shows and then found out that I have no way of downloading that video. So Twitter essentially owns my video. And I did not like that. I want to have a copy of my video, which on YouTube I can. So that's why I'm on YouTube. But I'm still doing Twitter for this, because I know for the last drive-in, y'all like be on Twitter. It just kind of makes the night, you know, cohesive and a little easier to just stay in one place. I get it. But when we do start the next series, which is coming up in, what did I say, 3 weeks, 2 weeks, 3 weeks. When we start that new series, it is going to be YouTube exclusive. I'll be promoting it on Twitter, but if you want to watch it, you're going to have to go over to YouTube. So go over there, give me a subscribe. If I can get 1,000 subscribers by summer, Once this quarantine thing kind of loosens up here in Chicago, I'm going to be going remote like I did last summer. I did several shows remotely. I did one down by the river where we made yummy little shrimp bites that Miss Laura Bierman loves. Joe Bob's little, not little, sorry, Joe Bob's blogger. She has told me she loves that recipe. Super quick and super easy. And we did it so super quick and so easy that I put all the ingredients in a backpack. And a couple of little things I needed to make it, and did it right down by the Chicago River live. So if you want to see content like that, make sure you are subscribing to, please, I need 1,000 before they'll let me go live from the phone. Right now I'm using a camera. So, all right, last tater. Tatoes. I got the oil on. I think I told you that, so make sure you get that oil going. So you're just going to let this sit, and you are going to notice the water's going to get all brown and discolored, and that's all the starch coming out. That's what's happening when you let a peeled potato sit. It gets brown and kind of funky, like a rust color. That's all that starch coming out. It's oxidizing with the air and the starch, making it funky. All right, that's it. See how easy that was? And that's a ton of fries, and that's easily going to feed 4 people, easily, because you're putting chili on this, and, you know, that's a lot. Okay. Oh, nope, I need this for the onion. All right, now we're going to just let that sit, and I'm going to have some beer. How are we doing on time? Awesome. Get this pan heated up on medium. Yep, and the first thing we're going to do is we're going to take that 1 pound of ground beef. We'll start the chili now. Get that in the pan. Okay. Cool. Yep, and you can hear that sizzle. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this wooden spoon. You notice I use a wooden spoon a lot. I just like the wooden spoon. It's what my mom always used, so... Plus, when you're using a non-stick pan, keep forgetting, look at you guys over there. When you're doing a non-stick pan, the wood doesn't scratch the Teflon or whatever your non-stick coating is. So just go up and down like this and really get that beef broken up. I'm going to pause for breaking it up here for a second. But I can't read that. There we go. We're in high. Okay. Let's start cutting this onion. We're going to do a nice small dice on this onion. I'm not going to tell you how to cut an onion again because I think I've told you like 40 times. If you're new, go back to one of my older videos for the Mutant Cafe technique of cutting an onion. You do want a nice small dice on these though. Same thing with your garlic. Because really... Like I said, there's no beans in this, there's no peppers in this, there's no tomatoes in this. It's a very, very basic chili, but man, is it full of flavor. I think the reason it's basic is because you're putting it on a Coney, or a hot dog, or you're making a Coney, you're putting it on a hot dog and on a bun, and you just don't need a bunch of stuff like falling off, especially with their Coneys, because you can get them with, you know, loaded with peppers and things like that, so... Just makes it a little easier when there's nothing in the chili. And again, you don't need it. There's so much spice going on here with this chili that you just don't need it. All right. Let's cook it up here. Just keep, again, breaking it up as it cooks. You don't want any big clumps. You want this to almost be a pureed in a way. Nice tiny little chunks. Okay. Now you could add beans to this. They do have a chili with beans. I think they probably take this as a base and then they add beans into it when they serve, you know, would you like a salad or a cup of soup? You get the chili. I'm pretty sure that has beans in it. It's probably the exact same recipe, but they just put in navy beans, would be my guess.
Kidney beans.
Yeah. If you ever get to Detroit, you definitely got to get to a Coney Island. They're amazing. So good. They're open, some of them, most of them, 24 hours. There were two downtown, I believe, my brother told me. One of them finally bowed out to the other one. But, I mean, they were rivals for 40, 50, 60 years. I don't know how long. Long, long time. It's just getting nice and browned up. That's exactly what we want to see. Okay, just kind of flatten it out. Use the whole pan. You don't need it all thick because then the top isn't cooking and the bottom is getting overcooked. So get it nice and flat. So go quick. Okay, get that garlic diced up. Small cutting board again. My brother's biggest pet peeve is my small cutting board. If you've got any questions, let Hub know. And I'm not gonna be all fancy with this dice here on the garlic. Just get it nice and small. Don't want a big giant chunk of garlic. You want it all kind of combined in. All right, how about guesses? Movie guesses. Who's got what? I think Joe Bob's clues were movie one is Twisted Morals, movie two is Twisted Metal, I think you said. I guessed Poltergeist for the Twisted Morals because they moved the headstones, but they didn't move the spoiler. That seemed like a Twisted Moral to me. Although I think Poltergeist is a little too mainstream for the Joe Bob Last Drive-In, but it'd be fun, and I'm tired of guessing and losing every week, so I'm just going to guess the movies I want to see. But the second one, I got for the Twisted Metal, Tetsuo, I'm going to say it wrong, Tetsuo, I think it is, The Iron Man. It's a Japanese film, it's black and white. I just saw it at, here in Chicago, Music Box Theater. You've heard me talk about it before, the 24-hour horror marathon. Hopefully we're doing this October, although I'm guessing not. I don't know that they'll have it. We did buy tickets, just in case. Anyhow, 3 o'clock in the morning, I think it was, 2 o'clock in the morning, 3 o'clock in the morning. Man, is this movie effed up. Super, super fun, though. Like, weird, weird, weird. Great music. Unbelievable visuals. Like I said, black and white. It's kind of a love story, but at the same time, this dude is turning into like metal, and then his girlfriend's turning into metal. It's the weirdest movie. So hard to describe. But the imagery and stuff, it kept me awake at like 3 o'clock in the morning. Hubs did not stay awake, I don't think.
Nope.
Nope. It was at 3 o'clock in the morning. It's kind of hard. I get it. All right, so there's just a tiny little bit of pink going on here, and I'm good with that because this is going to keep cooking. So what we're going to do next, I think, is the onions, right? No, I'm sorry. Salt and pepper. I'm going to go very, very lightly again on the salt because we are putting celery salt in here, but I do just want just a touch. Lots of pepper. Get that pepper in there because it is chili.
He guessed that same movie. He said you can read his mind.
PJ?
Yeah.
That's a great movie. It's an awesome movie. All right. And then we're also going to put in the cumin and the celery salt and the chili powder. My chili powder has a lot of adobo spices. Like those adobo. We just did adobo in, what was that in? Oh, the dipping sauce for the
pickles.
Yep, for the pickles. So get that mixed in. Basically what we're doing now, because there's not a lot of oil here now, again, because I use the meat that doesn't have a lot of fat, we're toasting the spices on the pan. Okay, because this pan is pretty dry. So we're just giving this a minute. And again, keep going up and down because I see some chunks in here and I don't want any big chunks. Right. Any other guesses? Any? It's hard to guess. I feel like it surprises me when Darcy says every week, like, 20 people got it right. And I'm like, how did 20 people get it right? 20 people just guessed and got it right. I'm not jealous or anything. I got one right last season. But I was like one of, I think, 50. I think it was an easy one. He was much easier last season. He's torturing us this year. Hey, onions and garlic in. We're just going to cook these for about 4 minutes until it's translucent. Right? Now we're done. No, we're not. Some tomatoes to cut. Let's clean up this board just a touch. Look, we're almost done. Look at these ingredients are all. Get that nice and incorporated. You can chop up any of the little onion pieces if you may have cut a little too big. Okay, a couple minutes here. And already the onions are turning a nice orange pink, picking up all that spice. Yummy, yummy. Okay, let's get that cooked down. Just a couple minutes. I'm going to leave it alone. Again, use all of the pan. I don't want to see any bottoms of pans. Get it all spread out so it's cooking. Great. Get it too thick of a layer. That stuff on the top is not cooking. I mean, it is, but it's cooking slow. And the stuff on the bottom is overcooking. So here we go. Nice and spread out. A little beer. I'm almost out of these. How many we got? 3 12-packs, 4 12-packs for the season? Almost none. Good thing, too, because Vinny's is closed. It is hot here in Chicago. I don't know how it is where y'all are. All right, let's talk about the last 2 weeks of State Fair food. Last week, I'm really going to apologize right now. Someone in the YouTube studio or YouTube chat room suggested fried green tomatoes, and that really, really caught my attention. I love fried green tomatoes. I love, love, love fried green tomatoes. They're one of my mom's favorites. But what I do, so we are doing that next week, but what I do is I like pink or fried pink tomatoes. I like them when they're still green, but they're just starting to get that tiny little blush of pink. I feel like when you do a fried green, like a solid, you know, candy apple green, it's just the apple doesn't, or the apple, the tomato does not get cooked enough by the time your crust is ready. So by the time the coating is cooked up, your green tomato is still a little bitter and too firm to me. So I get them when they're just a tiny bit pink. So when you're buying your tomatoes for next week, get them green, but you want to see just the fairest hint of pink if you're buying them a couple days ahead of time. Keep them away from the bananas. Keep them away from the avocados and the apples, anything that's emitting any kind of gas that's helping things ripen. Keep them by themselves, and you want them just flushed pink. I used both of the ones I had today, or I would show you one. That way, by the time your coating is nice and crispy, your tomato is starting to get soft. And it also has a little better flavor, in my opinion. So next week, we are doing fried pink tomatoes. We're not stopping with that. We are gonna top it with a delicious goat cheese and honey drizzle. Delicious. If you are the one who suggested it, please let me know, because I wanna make sure to give credit next week, because that's a fabulous Southern State Fair food. Delicious, delicious, delicious. If you've never tried it, please try it. We're doing a nice cornmeal plus corn flake coating on it, and it gets super crispy. And like I said, that pink tomato on the inside stays really juicy and starts kind of softening up a little bit. And then you put that goat cheese on top of it, which just slightly starts to melt. You drizzle over that honey. Man, is it good. Delicious. And then the week after that, because it's the finale of The Last Drive-In and the finale of Mutant Cafe, we are going to do a special, slightly longer, probably about 15, 20 minutes longer. So you're going to go into Ernie, or we're going to go into Ernie. So you'll miss the first 20 minutes of staring at Ernie in the trailer. But we are heading outside, and I am going to make, because someone also suggested a couple weeks ago how much they love sausage and peppers and onions. Sausage and pepper and onions, there's really no recipe. It's sausage and peppers and onions on the grill. Not a recipe. So what we're going to do is we're going to take our sausage and peppers and onions outside, put them on the grill, add some tomatoes. We're going to grill some tomatoes on the grill too. And I'm going to show you how to take all of that and make an amazing bucatini pasta sauce to go with the peppers and onions and sausage, spicy sausage. So that's what we're going to do for that. It's a little bit of a cheat. You can see where we're going with the state fair. You obviously don't get pasta at the state fair. Maybe you do, but you get where I'm going with it. And it's going to be a special live show. I may do some cosplay. I haven't really decided yet because I'm going to be outside on the grill. I think maybe the outside grill will be the cosplay. How about that? Sound fair? Sounds fair. All right, we're going to put in ketchup, mustard.
Ketchup, tomato paste.
Tomato paste, mustard, brown sugar.
Pete wants to know what your go-to onion is.
I like a Vidalia. I get a Vidalia. We can get them here in Chicago pretty much all year long, which is awesome. I know maybe, 5 years ago, 6 years ago, they weren't as popular. You couldn't get them all year long. You could only get them when they were in season or for the Vidalia festival that they have. I think it's Georgia.
Yep.
But now you can get them all year long. They're a little sweeter. They're not as harsh. That yellow onion has kind of a harsh kind of kick to it, which bugs me a little bit. So I go with the Vidalia. Just a little sweeter.
Jared said both Lafayette and American Coney are back open now.
Oh, right on. So it's Lafayette and American Coney if you go to Detroit. They both are pretty much the same. I don't know that there's a huge difference. I think one has alcohol, one doesn't. Maybe that's the difference. Two of them downtown, the two original ones, and they're literally like there's two streets. They're both on, in the middle of the two streets, which cracks me up. So you could technically hit them both on the same time if you wanted. But man, they have gyros that are amazing, which is a lamb on a spit with pita bread and hummus and olives. They do amazing milkshakes. So check them out. That's what this is all based on. It's quite similar. Hubs gave it a try and was like, holy crap, that really tastes like it. So give them a try. This is worth it, especially if you're not in Detroit. Now, if I can get their lemon rice soup, man, their lemon rice soup is amazing. All right, so I'm going to kick up my oil to make sure we're up to temperature because we are just about done here. So what we're going to do now is we're going to put in the stock.
Oh, and they're cash only.
Oh, are they cash only now? That's not shocking. Pretty much everything's cash only now. Contactless delivery and bizarre time we're living in, y'all. Okay. Oh, and by the way, for those tomatoes, I'm getting special maters from Brittany. Long, long time kitchen mutant Brittany. She is sending me her first harvest, or part of her first harvest, of her Texas maters. I saw pictures of them. Man, do they have a good, I'm excited. Very excited to use those fresh off the vine. She mailed them out yesterday. I'll have them here Monday or Tuesday. They're still green, with just a tiny little bit of pink. So they're going to be perfect. I can't wait. A couple of them looked heirloom, which is even more awesome. All right. So we are just going to let this simmer down for about 15 minutes. Yep, we're doing good. Just going to kind of mix these potatoes up. Make sure your potatoes are completely covered with water, by the way, or they're going to turn a little brown. Let's get that back out there. So we are going to do the switch here in a second, and I'm going to bring the oil over and put the chili over there somehow. I didn't think this through very well. Again, I need a double burner. Maybe season 2 of Mutant Cafe, which is coming up. We're not really taking a break or anything, but season 2 is coming up. And if you missed the announcement last week, we're doing MC52. 52 recipes we're hitting. And we're also about to hit 1 year come later in the summer. So we are going to, on Wednesday nights, probably about the same time, jump on YouTube and y'all are going to watch rebroadcasts of all 52 recipes. I'm going to do special commentaries at the beginning of the episodes for some of them, maybe not all of them. A couple other little special things I'm going to do with some of those episodes. So many of you are new and haven't watched all of these episodes, so it's a great way to just kind of check these episodes out again. That'll premiere, I don't have the date, but it's the week after the last drive-in's over, so in 2-3 weeks, that Wednesday, same time, same bat time, same bat channel, right here on this YouTube, we'll be chit-chatting. I'll actually be able to be in the chat room, so you can ask me questions and things like that. And then that Friday, don't forget, Mutant Cafe, MutantFam.com, and Mutant Theater 2 are back in action with Friday Night Frights. We are already talking. We got some great things planned for you guys. So don't be sad that Joe Bob is going away. Well, be sad that Joe Bob and Darcy are going away, but the Mutant Fam's not going away. We all still hang out on Friday nights with Friday Night Frights. That starts, we haven't exactly set the time yet. I think I'm going to keep the same time, which is 7 o'clock Eastern time, and then we do a double feature still of two movies, but they wrap up a little earlier, and then at midnight, you're going to get to jump over to MutantFam.com or onto their YouTube channel, and they do Midnight Marathon, excuse me, which is always great content. Sometimes it's a bunch of YouTube creators, content, little 10-minute, 15-minute, 30-minute, jumble of things. Sometimes you get a great movie. They also do the movies from the Madhouse. It is an amazing video, YouTube content. Those two hosts are amazing. They're kind of like Joe Bob. They sit on a couch. You get to watch an old movie that's royalty-free, and they break it up, and they do little commentaries in between the movie. Sometimes they do that. So anyhow, that all starts the week after Joe Bob and Darcy are done. So the party does not end. Make sure you check out Friday Night Frights. And again, if you need more details on that, they will be coming from Mutant Cafe. They'll be coming from MutantFam.com, and they'll be coming from Mutant Theater 2. Mutant Theater 2 is kind of our concierge. He kind of takes you through the whole evening, and they also host the two movies. So I'll be at the beginning, then two movies, then the marathon from the Midnight Marathon from MutantFam.com. Cool. Let's do the swap. This should be interesting.
Put it behind you. Put it behind you on top.
Cool.
Just
yeah. Actually.
Just, I mean, just to do the swap.
Shh. Got it. No, I don't. Yeah, I do. Excuse my head. Hello. And hello. Let's get this pan. Super hot oil, so I'm being very careful. Oh, super hot oil. And we fill the pan about a third to a half, right? All right, let's get the sun here. And that's why we're going to get a double burner for season two. All right, let's get that in here. Sorry, Hubs. Hubs is holding our apples. How you like them apples, Hubs? It's less than amused. Did I mention it's hot in here? It's so hot. We're two big boys. It's very hot. All right, so we're gonna kick this oil down. Ooh, it's hot. Yeah, let's kick that down. All right, so we only want this at 300. It's at about, right? Yeah, 300. Great, it's a 350, not bad. So I'm gonna take this out because this is gonna get a little crazy. All right, so we're gonna take a towel. Make sure this is an old towel because this could stain a little bit from the, again, from the oxidation here. And you want two nice big handfuls. Dry them off because you do not wanna put water in the oil, because you know what'll happen then. If you don't know what happens then, go ahead and try it. Don't try it, please. I don't want to be sued. All right. I got really fuzzy on that camera, I don't know why. All right, and then we're just gonna gently take these handfuls, get them in that oil, and kick that back up. There we go. See, again, that's why we only go about halfway. To see how it's bubbling up. And if you had a full pan there, that would completely bubble up. That would hit your flame, and it would be catching on fire. So I'm just going to slowly kind of separate those fries out. All right. Also, we're going to get some paper towels ready. Because these are only going to stay in for 4 to 6 minutes. Now, what we're doing right now is we're cooking the inside. That's why it's at a lower heat. Let's go that way. There we go. Hopefully you can see that. Yep, you can see that. All right. There we go. See, that temperature already came down. Now, I'm not going to do all four potatoes. I'm just letting you know. It's 6:40, so I'm just going to do one nice healthy batch here, and then you guys can just continue through the last driving countdown or whatever you're doing this evening. Okay, but you can already see these are starting to pick up a nice little faint color. That's good. I'm going to throw these back in the water. Yum, who doesn't like fries? Is there anybody out there that doesn't like fries? I don't believe you if you say you do. While we're waiting for that, let's cut these tomatoes. Bigger ones, I'm gonna go quarters. Smaller ones, go halves. That's the fun part, this is where we just put it all together. Now, obviously, you can put ketchup on your fries. Here in Chicago, we don't put ketchup on our chili fries, but that's what you like. Feel free.
Here, the mail order Coney kits.
Can I mail order Coney kits?
No, not can you. He just said mail order Coney kits, so I don't know if he means you or
who, Jared?
Yeah.
My brother? Yeah. Details, please. Excuse me. All right. Tomatoes are cut. That's it. All right. These are, see how quick that is? 4 or 5 minutes. They're starting to just get golden, cooked nice. All right. So we're just going to drain these on the paper towels. Do one more batch because this went so quick. Because Hubs and I are starving. No salt yet because these are going to go back in. Right? We're just going to let this come up to temperature just for a minute. And I'm going to drain one more big handful. Again, just make sure they're nice and dry. Also, make sure you don't have any little slivers because those slivers are going to burn, make your oil get all burned. Ooh, it's hot in here, y'all. Tell us summer. It's time for summer shows. No more grease. Stop asking for grease. Daddyman's fat. Not that there's anything wrong with that, but I feel fat because of, you know, I don't realize I have to test these like 4 times. So.
American Coney Island in Detroit has mail order Coney kits.
Oh, well, there you go. American Coney Island in Detroit has mail order kits. So if you don't want to do this, you can get it to go and mailed to you. But I suggest you do this. You saw how easy it is. It's really not that hard. All right, back in the oil. Yep, and you should get that immediate popping up. I mean, to be honest, these are super good already. So they're cooked on the inside. They're just a little flimsy. They don't have that crisp, and that's what we're going to do next. So we get rid of this. Stir these around. This is a spider, by the way. If you happen to see this, we got this in an Asian market. It's a nice big basket spider. perfect for something like this. Peanut oil is amazing for this, by the way. Typically, we don't, we were talking about, you know, vegetable oil, canola oil, and peanut oil is great for this. I don't know about peanut oil and Crisco. I don't know how well those play together, but peanut oil on the whole is great. So, again, you're going to continue. It'll be about 4 or 5 batches by the time you're done, depending on your potato size.
Mutant Foodie said you can get one of the spiders on Amazon as well.
Of course. What can't you get on Amazon? You can literally, my dad said, get a coffin on Amazon. But thank you. Yeah. And thank you to the people at Amazon right now for getting our stuff to us. Because right now, going to excess stores is scary. And thankfully, we just got a bike from Amazon. We do all kinds of stuff from Amazon. So thank you, Amazon. Okay, keep going here. A couple minutes. I feel like I want to reveal what the thing is, but I'm not going to do it. I'm like a little kid. I want to tell you what the next big theme is. It's super fun. You guys are going to love it, man. We had the first one, and Hubs was like, holy cow, it's so good. You guys are really, really, really going to like it. I see Chris is in the chat room from Mutant Theater, too. No spoiling, Chris. Another one of these, please. Took my father's recommendation and didn't pull the beers out because they got way too warm. There's Hub's hand. Hub's was in the New Year's Eve. If you happen to watch that one, we'll do that again this year. We decided every New Year's Eve, I'm going to do the exact same recipe and just kind of mix it up a little bit. And that is the Tipsy Cake. It's an amazing cake, vanilla cake, and it's got fruit, and it's got cherries and pineapple and vanilla pudding and whipped cream, and you just keep layering it and layering it and layering it. And if you watched it, we pulled those cakes out of the oven and gave them like 2 minutes to cool down. And I put them out in Courtney's hands, and they were steaming, and poor Courtney was like, ah! But she was a trooper. So we will continue to do the layer cake, and you'll get to see Hubs on New Year's Eve. It's in his contract, New Year's Eve only. All right, so these are done. Just one more minute. Any other questions for me? So yeah, next week is the tomatoes. So you'll need about 4 tomatoes. You'll need cornflakes. I actually used, what is it?
Honey bunches of oats
and kind of picked out those weird crunchy bits and just used the flakes from that. It gives it an extra honey thing. You can just use normal corn flakes. That's fine. Cornmeal you'll need. A goat cheese. So those are kind of weird items that you might need to start looking for now. And then the following week is so super easy. You're going to need a couple nice big beefsteak tomatoes, some big giant sausage links of your choice, green peppers, red peppers, yellow peppers, whatever kind of peppers you like, a couple onions, some garlic. That's about it. And then a nice big bucatini, which is my favorite pasta. All right, so these are now done. So what we're going to do is we're going to pull this up, and we're going to raise that temperature up by about 25 to 50 degrees-ish. Again, always go a little higher because once you put the potatoes in, it drops that temperature. We're going to finish them off, and this is what's going to make them nice and crispy on the outside. Don't try to grab all of them at once. It's not going to happen. You don't want these falling back into the oil and splattering on you. There we go. All right, so let's let this go back up to temperature. clean some of the oil off the table. So we are going to grab our chili. We got our tomatoes cut. We got our cheese at the ready. Don't need the salt and pepper. We'll put the chili right there. Oh yeah, nice and thick and ready to go. Check that out. Yum. Look at that. Nice, thick chili. All cooked down. I'm putting these on my awesome pot holders from Tales from the Stitch. Thank you, thank you. My Freddy Krueger pot holders. If you have a podcast or you do some kind of creations or something horror related, please feel free to contact me in the DMs. I would love to put your stuff up here. I got a nice piece of artwork from my best friend Courtney, also from the New Year's Eve episode. She did a little ghost Daddyman's Mutant Cafe. That's been up there for a while. But I'm looking for some more things. I did order the Joe Bob figurine, limited edition. I'm lucky enough to get in and get that. So if you got something you want to promote, please feel free to send it my way. I will get it up there behind me on every episode. So this is almost up again. We're going to get these fries back in. Kind of cooled down so I can touch them. There we go. Yep. Perfect. All right. These are going to take a matter of minutes. 2 minutes, probably. Get the big sea salt, big flaky sea salt at the ready. Regular salt is fine. I like the sea salt. It's nice and flaky. I like those big chunks of salt kind of when I bite into it. Just about done. How easy was that? Help said easy, because he just stood there. Any questions from the audience? Thanks, YouTube, for letting me know that my show is live 45 minutes late. It just popped up on the screen. Hey, y'all, Mutant Cafe started 45 minutes ago. Okay, these are almost done. These are so brown and crispy and yummy. And to be honest, sometimes you go to the fair and they're all floppy, and it's because they, you know, they're Russian. They got huge orders. It's got a huge line. They don't have enough time to let the oil go back up. You got all the time in the world, right? Make these perfect for your family or just for you. Because why share? So we are going to drain these. So I'm going to kind of push them away from that other side, from the other batch, excuse me. But one more minute on these, and then we're going to assemble these together. Yep. Oh, I can't wait. So good. You cook a lot in the kitchen. You get an asbestos mouth, asbestos fingers. Tolerate that heat. Yum. Yum, yum, yum. All right. Notice I'm just kind of pushing these around. Make sure it's getting all the sides, because you got an upside that, you know, isn't getting a ton. So kind of flipping them over. All right, let's get these out. They're done. Yum-ay-vu. I mean, these not only taste like fair fries, but they look like fair fries. Then we're going to put this chili on them. The fair is going to be jealous because you do not get these at state fairs. Get them in Detroit, though. I mean, really, these fries are done so well. You could top them with a lot of things, and they will hold up. These are nice, firm French fries, and they're super fluffy on the inside. They're not overcooked on the inside because you did that. Perfect. Oh, I love these. Just gonna pat dry, get some of the oil off. Don't need to get all the oil off. Throw these in there. But just get a little bit of the oil off. You don't want them to be too greasy. There we go. All right. Pat these down a little bit. Hit them with some salt. way up high. Okay. Get these on the plate. Ooh, they're hot. Could be using tongs, but whatever. There we go. Okay, and then all we're gonna do top it with a little bit of chili. Okay, right there in the center. Leave those ends out. Touch more. That. Oh. And then quickly hit it with that cheese. Much cheese or as little cheese as you want. Mustard. Ha-ha. Let's see if you guys can see it. And tomatoes. And that is the dish. Y'all did it. 45 minutes or so. You just made Detroit Coney Island French fries. There you go. That's it. Delicious. Try one? Okay, if I must. That's it. Now I gotta talk. Thank you guys so much for joining me again this week. Have that chili. I'm telling you what, it is so good, delicious with that mustard, just perfect together. So give this a try. If you didn't try it tonight, try it this weekend. As you saw, it did not take that long at all. Give this a try. Your family is really going to be thankful that you did. I super appreciate you guys joining me. I will see you again next week when we do those fried pink tomatoes with goat cheese and a nice little honey drizzle. Fried, but it's pan fried. It's not deep fried. It's fried in just a tiny little bit of butter. Maybe a stick. Just a tiny little butter. Thank you guys again for joining me. I will see you in the tweets in 1 hour for the last drive thing with Joe Bob and Darcy, and Ernie will be there too. Who knows what we're going to get tonight? Thank you guys again for joining me. Let me grab the Twitter and let you get a nice close-up look of these delicious fries. There you go. Check them out. Give us a try, guys. Thank you, Twitter. I so appreciate you. And let's get my YouTube. Hey, YouTube. Thank you, guys. There's your fries. Look how good those look. Let me get one of those out of there. Mmm, look at that. Oh, my mouth. Mmm. Thank you, guys, so much for joining me. See you guys in the tweet in about half an hour. Thanks for joining me.